Welcome back, students. So let's continue our discussion of the chapter Silk Road, which is written by Nick Middleton. In the previous video module, we have learnt that the narrator, finally Nick Middleton, he saw or he met another character, that is Nobu. Who is this Nobu character? As we have seen in the previous video module, Nobu is the character who is a Tibetan working at an academy in Beijing, who wants to carry out the pilgrimage to Mount Kailash. He was also leading towards the same place there. He wanted to carry out the pilgrimage. And when the narrator was reading, he was carrying English book. Now from the front cover that he realized, Nobu realized, and he inquired the narrator that, "Are you English?" The narrator said yes. Because the narrator was carrying at that time, holding English book, front cover specially, words were in English, so that's why he understood and he asked. And then onwards, that they struck up in a conversation. Struck up means started their conversation. Now we will continue the next part of this lesson. See now, then the next, "I didn't think that he was from those parts because he was wearing a windcheater and metal rimmed spectacles." Looking at his appearance or the wearing, the narrator says that "I didn't think that he was from those parts." Those parts means from that same land, from the same region there, part. "He was from those parts because he was wearing a windcheater." Windcheater means a kind of a jacket. Who was wearing? Nobu, this character. He was wearing a windcheater and a metal rimmed spectacles of a western style. So that's why the narrator assumed that he was not from the same region or the part. So he was Tibetan, he told me. And Nobu himself told to the narrator that, "I am Tibetan, but I am working where I work in Beijing." Who? Nobu. But he worked in Beijing at the Chinese Academy of Social Sciences in the Institute of Ethnic Literature. And where he worked, Nobu, though he is a Tibetan, but he worked in Beijing for what? Especially in the Academy of Social Sciences in the Institute of Ethnic Literature in Beijing. I assumed that he was on some sort of field work. And narrator, he considered that Nobu, that he was on some sort of field work there. "Yes and no," he said. Who said? When the narrator asked him, that time Nobu replied, "Yes or no. Maybe yes, and here on some sort of field work, or maybe no." Then, "I have come to do the Kora." Who said? Nobu said, "I am here to do the Kora." Kora means it's a kind of pilgrimage. "My heart jumped." And when Nobu said, or he said to the narrator that, "I am here to do the Kora, I am going towards Mount Kailash," that time the narrator's heart jumped. It means he became happy. Nobu had been writing academic papers about Kailash Kora, about the Kailash Kora and its importance in various works of Buddhist. And that time Nobu, that he had been writing an academic papers there. For what? Academic papers especially, and its importance in various works of Buddhist literature for many years he had been writing. And he told me, who told Nobu, told to the narrator, what? But he had never actually done it himself. Though he had been writing academic papers about this place or its importance, especially in the Buddhist literature for many years, but Nobu told to the narrator that he had never actually been there, done it. What? Kora. First time that he was going towards Mount Kailash to do the Kora. Though he had been writing academic papers, but actually he had never done it. So then, when the time came for me to tell him what brought me to Darshin, his eyes lit up. When the narrator told him that, "I am here," or what? "I am also here to do the Kora, I am going to do the Kora towards Mount Kailash. That time the narrator noticed that Norbu's heart, that it lit up. It means he became also happy, excited, and he said that we could be a team then. Norbu said to the narrator, yes, then we could be a team, we could go together. He said excitedly, two academics who have escaped from the library. Escaped from the library means here, remove themselves from academic work. Because both Norbu and the narrator, Norbu said to the narrator that we could be a team, we could move ahead, and then the two men or the two academics escaped from the library, means remove themselves from the academic work. Then, perhaps my positive thinking strategy was working after all, and then the narrator, then he assumed that when he thinks that, or he thought at that time that his strategy that was working properly there, his planning, whatever. So, children, in this way we have discussed here two, three small paragraphs. Now only the concluding part of this chapter is left, that we will conclude in the next video module. Thank you.